Thank you. Thank you. Ahora que está. Ya, mesti minta gue dia kena.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad I know.
So they can put it.
Aye. I have it, I just have it for now.
Anytime, you just drop it off the bus.
Aye.
Thank you.
assault. And there's help come on the staff. Coming from Sean, right? He's on. I wonder if guys are one to man.
something.
Thank you. one, two people on that beach. So when the church spread out, there's no one coming in.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Mind of the Silk of the Imami Conception and to the Thanksgiving service, funeral service for Brother Danny Jason Charline. I just want to remind us of our social distancing and the continued wearing of masks. As per the program, we have tribute and thereafter the eulogy.
I can still hear and feel him right. Having you.
in a medical shop. But the happiness we share in the last lifetime. And for that, I am forever grateful. As I close, I want to leave you some strong words as I am recording it. So do not be afraid, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your word. I will strengthen you, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. But there is a God, and his feet stand here. I need not say anymore. As Danny was saying, your test will come. Stand tall, head toes down. The marathon continues. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon.
We share food and bad times.
apologies. Miss Melissa Inglis.
The last thing he did
reciprocated the love to his father. It would be injurious of me to conclude without speaking to the immeasurable support Danny had from his mother Putin. Danny loved his mother from the depths of his heart, an unconditional love that was witnessed by many. As a young man, his aim was to see his mother happy. There was nothing that was within his powers that he would withhold from her. I close with this. You can tell the greatness of a man's life, not so much by his material wealth or glorious estates. On the contrary, the greatness of a man is the legacy he leaves behind. My friend, you have never been rich in money, yet you had a significant number of persons who lived, the generous, the generous touch, and the great love you shared with us all. I do know this. One day I will meet him again. I thank you.
Continue to cherish his precious name in your heart. Let me take this opportunity to extend my deepest sympathy to members of the Shannon family, relatives and friends, both here and abroad. chief at the South Junction Service, Sacred Andrew Edward. Family members will return to the church at the reception of the body and thereafter at the blessing and procession. Stand.
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
We shall now sprinkle the body of our brother with holy water as a reminder of his baptism. On the day of his baptism, Danny put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory. We shall now take the body of our brother to the altar in procession.
Let us all join in singing the entrance hymn, Canticle of the Sun.
Yeah. Thank you.
Nothing can come between us and the love of God. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be concerned after such a gift that he will not refuse anything he gave. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God chose, cannot anyone condemn, but only Christ Jesus. No, God only died for us. He rose from the dead and right at the and seated at the right hand, he stands and pleads for us. Nothing, therefore, can be between us and the love of Christ. Even if we struggle or wander, or be persecuted, or lacking food, or clothes, or being threatened, or even attacked, these are the trials through which by the power of him who loved us. For I am certain of this, neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor prince, nothing that exists, nothing shall come, not any power, nor height, nor death, nor any created thing can ever come between us and the love God made visible in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
My brothers and sisters,
behalf of the cathedral administrator and the parishioners of the Minor Basilica, we extend sincere condolences to the family, to the relatives and friends of our brother, Danny Jason Chapman. Normally, we do not call it a survey, so most of the time you will get the first name called by the first name, and you will say, hey, why don't you call the whole thing? But the whole point about it is, if you remember, at the beginning, we sprinkled the body with holy water as a reminder of his baptism. And at baptism, what the name he was given was Danny and Jason. Right? Some people might have four names, it doesn't matter. But the whole point is, just the same way that when Adam was into that, he named the objects around, God brought the objects to him. You know, the animals and the different plants, and he named them. So we are known by that name. So at baptism, when we come to be offered up to God, we are offered up under a name. And that's why it's important that we choose a good name for the person. You know, sometimes we have names and you cannot even pronounce it, you know. And sometimes it's embarrassing to the child who has that name, because you see what your name is, and then they'll ask you to repeat it, and they have to show it, you know. So one has to be careful, because the child has to grow up with the name. So now another children, when they grow up, they decide to change their name, and they take a part of their name and they use that name. Anyway, we are here to bid farewell to our brother, Danny Jason. And we have left our busy schedules to come here to wish him farewell. And some of you will be grieving in your heart because some of your friends, some of his friends are outside. And my dad, he came out today, everybody was going to be present. But we have a new protocol. And sometimes people think it's government that just have bad mind. But no, people are dying. They're dying around. Okay, we had two who died over the weekend. And we say, fortunately, two. But think if one of those belongs to you, it's not going to, because that person is precious to you. And that's what's going to happen. If we don't control it, if we don't take steps to deal with it, that virus is going to be with us for a long time. So we have to take the precautions so that we will have a better control. And what's worse is that we're fighting an enemy that we cannot see. The virus is something that we cannot see. It's everywhere, it's around us. We know that. But every time we group together, like over the Christmas season, people are having a good time. Then the numbers skyrocketed from 3 or 4 to 41, you know, in 1 week. So we have to be careful. What we should do is to ask God to bring an end to this. I know we have vaccine, and people are happy about the vaccine, but taking the vaccine does not guarantee you the safety. We don't know if there are after effects. We don't know if the vaccine is perfect. We don't know. We're trying it. Nobody knows enough about those things. So we are trying. So if you can avoid the circumstance where you are together and you are exposed to it, it's better. You know, we do the best we can. So brothers and sisters, we have to bear and make it a fight. It's a national fight. It's a national issue. I know it's upsetting, because when I myself came, I was coming through the side door. The side door was locked. So I had to walk around and find my way to the front, because all the other doors are closed. So I had to ask the policeman beside that, who is going to conduct the funeral ceremony for you? He says, well, we'll let you do it, you know. So it's embarrassing. is influential by the other one. And St. Paul tells us in a letter to the Romans, he says, alive or dead, we belong to God. Alive or dead, we belong to God. So that's what property there, right? This is Jesus, but he's God's property. God knows him by name. And then there is this passage where God says that I'm the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob. These are people who had come and gone, they are dead. But he's telling Moses that he is their God. They are dead, but he has a relationship with them. And then when Jesus at his transfiguration, he was there with Elijah, you know, and Moses. But he had died again. But yet he was conferring, and he was transformed that he had come as dazzling white. In other words, Peter, James, and John, who were there, they were scared. You know, they fell on their faces, they were scared because, hey, what's this? What does this mean to see? And then Jesus had to come and tell them, oh, we together. But God is ever present, and God is in control. And that is why, as a nation, as a people, we should intercede, we should ask God to have mercy on us. COVID-19. We have to pray and ask him. Because God says we have to pray and ask him. Right? Now, we are saying we are praying for loved one, and that's why we are here. So we are praying for the dead. Some people tell you, some religions tell you they don't really pray this prayer for the dead. But we as Christians, we know that God listens to the voice of and this is our loved one, but this is God's precious person there. God says he made each one of us in his image and likeness. Each one, not a parallel, but each one, you are made in the image and likeness of God, which means God cares for us. So whatever happens to Jason is a concern to God. Right? So we have to pray and ask God to have mercy. Now sometimes you see, you know, you look and you say this, and you see, this one says the funeral service, which has given for the lamb, okay? That's all right, of Jesus. But sometimes they say they come to celebrate the lamb, as no better they do. No, when we come before God, we come seeking his mercy. Right? Because it doesn't matter how much. Well, the eulogy was nice. Nicely was said about him. But in our own life, God has given us graces that we have not made use of. Sometimes we say, well, that was a very good person. Of course he was a very good person. But he or she could have been better. Because God, at the baptism, we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, apart from the beautiful name Jason and Danny, right? We receive the Holy Spirit, which means the Holy Spirit dwells in us during our lifetime, right? So, if that is the case, it means we are the temple of the Holy Spirit, because God lives in a temple, so our bodies are precious. Make temples of our lives. And so if we remember that, we respect each other. Apart from the fact that God says, longer than you are as yourself, right? We have to remember that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Right? And because we are the temple, it means even now, this is the temple of the Holy Spirit before us. And that is why we keep the body with respect. Even in death, we keep the body with respect. So brothers and sisters, we continue to pray for our brother, asking for God's mercy, and asking him to lead Daddy to his kingdom,
And at the same time, while staying here, we pray and ask the Lord to guide us in our own land so that we reflect His goodness. Right? So in other words, our land to bring glory to God. The things that we do, the things that we say, should bring glory to God. So we have to glorify God by everything that we do and everything that we say. And as a nation, as a people, just now we decided making our independence. 22nd of February, we will be celebrating. And we will, at the time, as a nation, because of COVID, but at the same time we ask God to bless our people and bless the nation. And we don't have to wait till independence. Even now, we can ask God to have mercy on us and to bless His people and bless His nation. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Who are stepping in the will of God in this evening. Lord, have mercy.
You want out.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Father, holy as and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Danny. Do not come with peace against him, for in his heart is desire to be your will. As his faith united him to your people, so may others enjoy him to the angels of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people pray unto you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
Come on. un petit peu.
Skip! Yeah.